like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
Call me Cardi B. I run this shit like cardio. Woo!
So for those of you who might be living under a rock, that was a little sample of WAP. And we're going to get to that in just a minute. But first we have what's good. Nan Lafferty sharing what her colleague did. It's a first grade teacher, a friend of hers, and she transformed her classroom, did this makeover so that it just wouldn't be so scary with all the dividers when the kids come into class and they're separated from each other as a way to social distance. And so she turned them into little trucks. How cute is this?
Oh my God, this is so cute. What a way to be creative. I just realized as you said that it's definitely gonna be an interesting adjustment for kids going back to school and being distanced, even for teachers having to reorganize the classroom. That is really cool though.
Yeah, and let's be real, she probably spent her own money. She probably had to dip into her own bank for this one. But teachers, they do this. You know, they do this for their kids. They want to make it more comfortable than ever. And, you know, most likely they're going to be wearing masks. So you already have that, you know, disconnect. And so this is just a cute way. And she personalized it with their names and everything. But just another example and another reason why our teachers rock. Happy to report we have an update on one of our first guests here on the Oh My Goff Show. Washington's football team, WFTs, I think that's the name we're sticking with at least for now. Washington football team's quarterback, number 11, Alex Smith. Yes, you can see champagne shower here, and with good reason, because it's been nearly 21 months since he had that awful, awful injury. 17 surgeries.
You know, a little different to look down at your leg like that and know that I obviously was a pretty severe break, but certainly I felt like, oh, the doctors will put me back together and you know, I'll do the rehab. And then obviously once the infection happened and the road that led us down, you know, where I would be now, I'm really thankful that I took some doctor's advice early on when we decided to document this, because it has been such a long journey.
Not only was the injury so horrible that it almost took his leg, but if you've been following his incredible journey.
See my thigh, that's skin from my thigh right there.
Through ESPN and Project 11, the documentary, you saw that it almost took his life. This has been in remarkable, remarkable story of persistence, perseverance, heart, dedication, and hard work. And it has been so, so exciting to see this moment where we see him in his pads on the practice field during training camp for the very first time in nearly 2 years. And in the family, his support system behind him is incredible too.
Liz, girl. I mean, thank God for her.
What they've been able to accomplish together really is nothing short of amazing. Also, we must shout her out for her incredible cake making skills, because this is pretty legit. Way to go here. I mean, even he wears that black stocking. I think she took a Sharpie to the leg.
They literally are like Ken and Barbie. So.
Oh, I know. Like, they're so beautiful. Like, it's ridiculous. Like, this should not even be possible.
I said certified freak, 7 days a week.
WAP, where are ladies at? WAP.
Oh my gosh.
Over.
There's a reason why everybody is talking about WAP. Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion, they are doing things. They debut at number one.
On the Hot 100.
93 million streams in the first week.
Crazy.
Okay. This is the most for any track in the first week of a release. 93 million streams.
Can we talk about this video though? This video, I mean, that's why I got this little hairdo today, a little bit of inspired Cardi with the nails. But the video, the production, everything was incredible. That's the best part about the song to me.
And it was shot during COVID. She said they spent $100,000 alone just on testing. It probably will go down as maybe the raunchiest song in Billboard history to reach number one. Yeah. And that's okay.
The cameos, I love. I am a fan of Mulatto. Kylie, mm-hmm. I mean, where do we even begin with this? Popped out, all in cheetah, looking like a bag of money. I'm not even going to hate. I love to see her in it. Cardi's response to the controversy of Get Kylie Out the Video was so dope in the sense of I wanted to showcase that all women of all different types of shades, colors, ethnicity have that WAP.
Yeah, it is very shocking. I mean, you can't look away. Own it, ladies. I think that if I were to get married again, that my wedding song might be WAP.
I can't.
Well, the slow dance with my husband.
Slow grind. That's what I'm saying. I miss weddings. Like,
right?
Dance and be sweaty and turn. Wow.
Well, they're saying in this age of COVID that it might actually change weddings as we know it for the rest of our lives. It's like a big wake-up call. They're realizing, oh my gosh, I was going to spend what? I was going to invite these people. And I'm stressed about this. This pandemic has really given us a new vision. That is what we're going to talk about today, because there is a trend taken off because people, they still want to get hitched.
Yeah, as they should, you know, but you got to be creative and kind of innovative with how you do it nowadays.
We met a couple that is about to take that plunge, and here's their story. We've obviously seen that this has been a tough year for weddings. Andrew, I want to begin with you. Your whole life is dedicated to planning. Okay. So I can't think of, you know, this disrupting anybody's life more than someone whose job is to know what's going to happen and to plan it and to make it go off without a hitch. How has this been for you?
It's like never coming back up. It's just a straight fall. And I'm waiting.
You better wear your mask.
Yeah. And I'm waiting to actually get back up and do a somersault or something.
But as a wedding planner and an event planner, the show must go on. People still got to live. And we're seeing in every industry, people are getting creative with how they're doing that. Tell me about this new trend that you're seeing with weddings.
Well, I think that people in the midst of COVID-19 and everything that's going on, you know, in this chaotic time, people are honestly looking to still have some type of normalcy in their lives. And for people who have already planned their wedding or even thought about having it in 2020, they're like, you know what? I am not going to let this pandemic destroy one of the most important aspects of my life. So what can I do to make it happen? And we've got, you know, constantly emails and phone calls from couples who are like, you know what? Are you guys still planning? Like, can we do something this year? And at first I was saying, man, I want to, but we can't, you know, it just is not physically possible. But then as we saw states start to slowly open up, I said, well, maybe we can opt for something on a much smaller scale. And that's how we started to form, you know, this micro wedding concept of really just trying to give people a sample of their ideal wedding. And that's where we are now. You know, we have a lot of amazing couples that are bold enough and brave enough to say, you know what, by any means necessary, we are going to get married in 2020.
We're seeing like stoop weddings. Like I saw in Brooklyn recently.
Yes.
Yeah, stoop weddings. I think this woman named Cece, who's on Basketball Wives, just got married in a live stream ceremony. I mean, the creativity is next level.
So I want to bring in this couple, these lovebirds, Tatiana and Guillermo. So you're from Bowie, Maryland. When you found out, or you saw the direction everything was going, tell us what your reaction was.
Well, I actually was planning a proposal in this past spring with all our friends and families together at the first place that we met, and just kind of surprise it with that. And then this happened. So just in line of what you're saying, I had to kind of like regroup, replan, and I did a Zoom proposal.
Okay, let's unmute our friends. We had a little computer set up, and I turned around, and there were like 40 people, like all of our friends, watching the Zoom, which was really cute.
Instead, so we still got to have everyone there, but just different ways, but at the end goal was the same. So that's
so cute.
How did you come across Tatiana and Guillermo, the idea of doing a micro wedding?
And just Googling, we came across Andrew's website, and I was immediately like, oh, this is fun. Like, his website.
Yes, SEO.
A great website, I will say that. That
was amazing. But look at him. Isn't he beautiful?
His background.
It's fun. Yes, it was gold, and there were greens, and people were dancing. And I was like, oh, yeah, I'm into this. And then we saw, like, the micro wedding thing, and I was like, oh, this is perfect.
I'm not going to let this, like, make us stop living, you know? Like, yeah. We're going to celebrate life. We're going to celebrate our love. And we're going to do it in a smart, mature way.
But it does kind of take that pressure off, right? It takes the pressure off of having... So is it almost like a blessing in disguise in some ways?
No, it is.
It really
and
is.
It was
really
important is. For me to not... I don't want to meet anyone at our wedding. Like, I want to come and see strangers.
Yeah. And
everybody who's coming to our wedding has shown us love. We love them. And we're all connected. I want to be able to feel the love in the room. And I know with a micro wedding, it's just going to be tons of love in the room.
I'm sure you guys had an idea in regards to what you were going to spend, and you're probably saving money right now.
Even getting married in North Carolina, the price of that is insane now. Most people think it's cheap, but you're looking at least $20,000 to $30,000. This is literally like 10% of that. Andrew has really just taken care of everything. Like, our outside expenses are just outside expenses. But as far as the core, 10%. My dad is very happy.
It's wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. We're doing ceremony cake, dances, and champagne.
I want to go to the event storyteller. You had to change how you were going to tell this story. If you're selling me the idea of a micro wedding, you come in, like, is it just like a kind of maybe an elevated Vegas style thing?
What? You have baseball caps, huh? And fancy calendars.
Some of this stuff happens on the same day, right?
It's not a drive-by wedding reception or a wedding ceremony. It's certainly not that, because that's not the business I'm in. But what happens is that we honestly give them this beautiful, glamorous space to have their wedding. It is the type of space that doesn't need any decor to actually, you know, make this space look like it's the perfect wedding ceremony location, but we still provide that decor for them. We create one day that houses four couples, but each couple is honestly a two-hour block to have their moment. Some of the couples opt for a mini reception, which increases their time frame for additional hours. So we give you the price of an elopement, but the glamour, the glitz, the pizzazz of a regular wedding. For Tatiana and Guillermo, they're walking in, and as soon as they come in, they have a tremendously amazing photographer who's been featured in places like Insight Weddings and Martha Stewart and all that. So very reputable people. We also have Chip Dizzard, who does videography. So he's the one that's giving them their live stream. All their guests have to do is click on the link, and they can see Tatiana and Guillermo's entire ceremony and everything that they're doing. Plus it has, you know, the cinematic extra. So it's just zooming in, different angles, all of these things, you know, come to life. But then we still give them that experience. Couples still want to cut their cake. They still want to do a champagne toast. They still want to do that first dance. And so we make all of this happen with all of our vendors. So it's not like they're purchasing this package and then having to go out and get a whole bunch of more vendors to be involved.
Wish I could do this all over again.
Location, where are we getting married?
We have three locations for our concept. Where Tatiana and Guillermo are getting married is at the Perry Belmont House, which is a phenomenal historic location in the heart of DC.
So we got around to doing a virtual tour, and we literally walked up to it. It's very like a video game, you know, you just walk up, you see the room, the petite salon that we're going to be in. And we looked at each other like, we're going to have to dress a little nicer.
On a spectrum, the cheapest you could get away with doing a good micro wedding to how high it can go.
So our starting package right now is $2,500 for micro weddings. However, we have had at least three couples that are doing a micro wedding go up to $10,000 to about probably $12,000 for their micro wedding for about 30 people. And that's because they're doing an elevated decor, but they're also adding in their reception, like a mini reception to that. Most of our weddings, or at least from what I've seen other people provide, it's at least between the $1,800 to the $3,000 price point.
How does that compare to what an average wedding costs to throw here in the U.S.?
So if I did this exact same thing, let's say for Tatiana and Guillermo, and they had 25 people, I'm at least looking at about $15,000. The benefit of our experience is the couples are sharing the cost of the venue space. When it's with a single couple, they're paying for everything.
So even though you're sharing the same space, no two weddings are going to look exactly alike.
Yeah. Like, we're working with each vendor individually to get what we want for our wedding. You know, so like the florist is going to do our blush and emerald. The cake is going to incorporate that.
Invitations?
Invitations are going to be to our liking, you know.
Oh, they do the invitations too?
Yeah.
No. Drew is that guy. Drew is that guy.
It really is. I'm like, when it's my time, I got to call him up.
Okay, let's talk about the dress.
It's fine. It's white.
Do you think that this pandemic is going to impact how the wedding industry goes forward and does things? And do you think it's going to impact how couples plan their weddings? Are we going to see a shift in the culture?
People want to party and people want to get out of the house. I think that the wedding and event industry is going to bounce back. I think what's going to happen is that the demand for space is going to increase. Retraining yourself on how you look at the wedding experience is really key, but also making sure that your budget includes PPE.
Even if you need to write down everything you want at your wedding, write that down and make a second column. Like, okay, what's essential? What do you actually need?
So what is the day? What is the big day?
It's 10, 10, 20.
Real quick.
He has a countdown.
Eight days, 2 hours, and 21 minutes.
Aw, I love that.
I can't wait.
10, 10, 20. That's great, guys.
And you already got 50 people coming. You got any open spots?
we got like an internal wait list.
I was about to say,
me and me, we'd be there. Like, we got dresses ready to go. Okay,
we got you.
I got some emerald, I got some blush. You need a bridesmaid? Hello.
How can people get in contact with you? I know, as people are going to watch,
all of our information is at andrewrobyevents.com. There you can find our Instagram, you can find our Facebook page, all of our social media. So, andrewroby, R-O-B-Y. events.com, and you can see all the information there.
We wish you nothing but the best, and you know, if that wait list does go down, you know how to reach us.
Yeah. Definitely will. We got you.
I love wedding cake so much.
Godspeed to you guys. We're so excited for your big day.
Thanks, y'all.
Thank you guys.
Bye. Talk soon.
Thanks everybody for joining us. This was really a fun episode, and we are powering through this pandemic, and we just want to really say thank you to all of our listeners and our viewers for sticking with us through these changes. It hasn't been easy for Brittany and I to be able to do this on split screen because we are such like annoyingly like personable people, you know. We really encourage you, if you haven't watched previous episodes, the common theme that you're going to find, no matter who we're interviewing or talking about, is the feeling of feeling good and us trying to do what we can to motivate you or to inspire you or just to put a smile on your face.
Yep, exactly. So don't forget to follow us on social at Oh My Goff Show on YouTube, search Oh My Goff Show, and subscribe today to keep up with us.
Yeah, and while I'm putting the plug out there, you know who's on Instagram now?
Who? Oh!
Yeah.
Show yourself.
After years and years of asking, she's had requests pretty much all her life. Ren on Reels, R-E-E-L-S.
Best Instagram name ever.
Ren on Reels.
Thanks for joining us. Don't forget to listen to our shows. Let us know what's good and wear your mask or.
Reminds me of like, I'm Luda.
Not only does it keep the COVID out, it keeps out the haters.
That will be up on our website as well, ohmygoff.com, if you want to buy it.
Yes, it is already under favorite things. Thank you. this morning.
What about the three and the notebook?
Well, I know it sounds absurd, but everyone's doing it.
I'm not telling you, I'm going to be.
Really?
Be.